All right, today we are back in DCS in the Huey helicopter. We're going to do search and rescue today in the Batumi area and surrounding region. So I'm warming up the engine as we speak, and once we get everything set and ready to go, we'll take our first job. So we've already got it up to speed, up to RPM. Gotta set our compass is off. So we'll do that. Right there. And what else? I'm going to turn on. We don't have our anti-collision lights or our position lights on. So we'll do that. And I always turn my position lights to flashing. So there we can see that. And our anti-collision light is flashing. We are good to go. And I believe that's everything. Everything's good. Everything's in the green. We don't need any radios today because dispatch is going to tell us exactly where we need to go. So we don't need to worry about any of that. All we need to worry about is getting in and out safely. I would say we're ready to go. We'll take our first job. Heatstroke patient 030, 32 nautical miles at the harbor. Okay. I usually set my compass just because. 030. I pretty much know where that is already anyway. So we'll actually go out straight out and then along the coastline. Ready to go, raise collective, get light, and into a fairly decent hover. Okay. And we'll just, instead of going out there, we'll just head toward the harbor. Just pretty much this way here. And then we'll find out what we're up against. Looks like a beautiful day though, nice and clear, not a lot of wind. Thinking we're probably, it does feel like there's a little bit of wind here. Yeah, from the smoke on the smokestacks there, you can tell we're kind of got a crosswind going. So remember that when we're landing, we'll land into the wind. I think along runway 24. I think it's runway 24. I'm not sure. But very close to that. As we get close, we'll start to slow down a bit. Take a look at what we got. There's a good safe place to land, how to get in there. We'll start slowing down now. So the harbor is just up here. And there's our smoke. Looks like he's on that little peninsula. So we'll come in off the water. Looks like the wind is going pretty much straight east now. And there. So that's the way we'll come in. Start slowing down, turning around. lowering our collective to try and drop some speed, nose up. And come around nice and slow. Watching our vertical speed, make sure we're not going to drop into VRS. Overshot just a little bit, so I'll have to just drop her down right here. Okay, and we'll take off straight over the water. Okay, probably shouldn't land in the smoke because you can't see nothing. You can see zero. Not good. All right, we're ready to go. If we can get out of here without dumping it in the water. Coming along the southern end of the airport. So I believe that's where the wind coming from. Pick up a little bit of speed here. There's the airport. much better approach. A little off, but that's okay. At least we're not crashing, which is the objective. And bring in for a nice landing here. Move over a bit. And there we go. Perfect. Very happy with that one. That one was very, very good. Take one more after this, once we've finished unloading the patient. And lots of fuel. Oh, I didn't drop any fuel. Usually I drop fuel. Why did that not work? Okay, anyway. Doesn't matter. I think we're okay. We're only transporting usually one patient at a time. Okay, 064, 5 nautical miles. Okay, so let's set up our... probably pretty close to there. And looks like we're going to be way up in the mountains. Let's take a quick peek. 064. And we're going to be way up in here. So, okay, so we'll just head straight over. Once we hit the river, then we'll kind of know we're in the right area, or fairly in the right area anyway. We got a ways to go anyway. Some speed. And up we go. I wish they would make some that are way, way up in the mountains, like where you have to... I mean, I know they're long missions, but, you know, I guess I could probably make my own. You know, like a way, way up in the mountains. So you have to go through some valleys and follow some waypoints and that type of thing. And then get into a tight spot and, you know, bring them all the way back to town. Because that would be like in real life, right? You know, these pilots that are out of travel 20, 30, 40 miles just to pick up the patient and bring them all the way back from a car crash or whatever, what have you. These are mostly in the town or very close to it. You know, 6 miles out is quite a ways when you're in a chopper, but well, not really. It only takes about 5 minutes. Not even that, really. You're cruising at 80 to 100 knots. I'm going to say kilometers, but it's knots. And I'm purposely keeping it between 80 and 100 because I find when I go a little bit too fast, it's hard for me to slow down properly, and then I keep overshooting, and then I get into trouble. And so I'm trying not to do that. I'm trying to be safe, trying to be a better pilot, and really watch the VRS. That'll get you pretty quick. You're not paying attention, and then you end up having a spectacular crash, which is okay too. I mean, that's how you learn, but I'd really rather not. And I really wish they'd do better with the graphics, you know. I mean, the graphics are okay for a game. They're definitely playable, but it could be a lot better. I mean, it could always be a lot better. And I have a feeling we're getting close to the river here. go here. Yep, we're getting fairly close. Actually, it'll be a little bit off to the left. Well, there we go. There's smoke. So we're going to start slowing down because we're going a little bit too fast. Well, we're going a lot too fast. Let's take a peek at what we got to do here. Okay, it looks like we'll come in from the northwest. Strip of land there. I'm definitely going into the wind here. Drop it down nice and slow. Ooh, that could have been a disaster. Get up over here and we'll turn. Did they already load him? Oh my lord, you were ready to go. You're supposed to wait until we actually stop. And I wonder if I can. No, I think he said we're ready to go, so I mean. Okay. Wow. That was interesting. So we definitely don't want to be going backwards. Going into the wind. There we go, nice and slow. Pick straight up and head back into town. Back in the same way we came through the valley here. Well, there looks like there's a fire truck there, so I think that's probably going to be another. So down there, a bunch of people. That looks like one of the ones we're going to get. We haven't been there yet, so. Alright, at least we know where that one is now. And we'll take maybe one more after this. That'll be enough for that video. That'll be long enough. Definitely getting back into the groove now. And we'll cut through here. Between these two peaks. I like doing this search and rescue there. I like playing, doing the guns and cannons and the door gunners too, and that kind of those kind of missions. But this is just nice sometimes when you just want to do a little bit of flying, get a little bit more competent, not a lot of pressure, and just take your time and, you know, don't kill yourself. Because flying the UH-1 is a treat in itself, and it's freaking awesome just to get in here and just feel it. Reminds me the summer I was in Northwest Territories, and I did some, what they call it, a CEFF, Certified Emergency Firefighter, and they would, we were on basically scrub missions on the cleanup, so they would take 5-6 guys in a chopper with all your equipment, all your hoses, your pumps, picks and axes and whatever else, and we'd go to a burn, and we would basically clean up the area with a lot of water, digging up the smolders, and just enjoying the wonderful summer weather, other than the fires, obviously, but yeah, you'd never really flown in a chopper until you've flown in a two-blade Huey 204. You just would not believe the rush and the power. It was pretty incredible. I enjoyed every minute of it. We were based out of Hay River. Way, way up there. So, well, not way up there, actually, just across the border. It was definitely a lot of fun. Hard work. And not a lot of pay, but it was an experience. And yeah, just watching the chopper pilots move around in the bush and stuff was, yeah, these guys are pros, man. It was a treat. Alright, enough of that. I've got to concentrate on when you're landing into the wind. That's why you're supposed to do it anyway, especially way out in the open, but you have more control when you're landing into the wind than, of course, when you're landing again with the wind. Yeah. It's hard to gauge that too, because you slow down so fast and you want to come in at a nice pace, but you know, 40 knots. It's not easy, but that's better. Once we get into ELT, then we can just kind of hover taxi. To our spot. So at about 5-6. Set her down. Perfect. That's way much better. Alright. I think I'm going to do one more. Just because I'm feeling good and I seem to be flying a little better today. A perfect landing starts with the perfect approach. That's one of the sayings. Alright, good. And we're going to take our last mission of the day. Injured swimmer, Batumi Beach, main beach northwest of lake, 02431, 3.1 nautical miles. 024? Alright. And we've still got lots of fuel. Oh yeah, pick it up, just beautiful. Oh, that's nice. That's exactly what I want. definitely fighting a headwind here. Try not to balloon up too much. He's along the beach here north of the lake. This isn't a lake, that's for sure. There's a lake over here somewhere? I remember seeing a lake, but... Oh, there it is. They must be talking about... Huh, interesting. Oh, they got a whole bunch of umbrellas down there. Okay, we should be able to nail this landing pretty good. Maybe not. Okay, we got him. That was not my best landing, especially with all the room that I had. That was not great. Okay, ready to go. Everything's clear over there. And again, we'll come in from the south end, because I believe that's where the wind at the airport is coming from the north. So we're going to land into the wind. And it definitely looks like the indications from the smokestacks here are the north-northwest. Green, everything's still looking good. Nice little town. And I think maybe the next one we'll do is a search and rescue in Dubai. I don't think I've done a one video on that, just to give you some scenery. And here we go, we're coming into the south end of the airport. nice and slow. The .500 feet per minute should do it. Try not to get too slow. Do about 40 knots. See if we can do a better landing. Get into a nice hover taxi. Yeah, this is way, way better. I'm very happy with that. That was a good mission, good landings, fairly good landings, some of them. Had pretty good control. Into a nice hover. Sit her down. Wonderful. Alright, thanks for joining me. Start the shutdown process. And we'll start lowering the RPMs. Low RPM warning, and we'll shut off the and take our first trim off. I believe that's that. All right, thanks for watching. Catch you next time.